Hello, hello! It's CEO here. And today, I want to show you my labyrinth island I've been building. I had the idea to make a maze island based off the maze minigame found in Animal Crossing New Leaf. The premise of the game is that you run around a twisted maze trying to collect a certain number of fruits before the timer is up. The game is super fun to play with friends, and I was a little disappointed when we didn't see a minigame update this summer for New Horizons. So I took it into my own hands to update Animal Crossing myself. So I set to work building my own maze minigame in Animal Crossing New Horizons. I started with a flat island and moved all the unnecessary buildings to the beaches. I also added cliffs and waterfalls along the entire perimeter of the island to create a defining boundary for the maze and to create an ethereal atmosphere. Since I was trying to capture the essence of the original New Leaf game, I knew I wanted the airport to be in the center of my island instead of at the bottom, since in the original game, you start in the middle of the island. My idea is that when visitors get off the plane onto my island, they are immediately taken into the gaming experience, with no need to walk to a starting point. I could have just had my maze start at the bottom where the airport usually is, but I like to do things a little extra. You may also notice that my town hall and plaza look a little off. Since visitors will need to drop their items at the end of the game in order for me to judge the winner, I remade the plaza using stone pathing, since players can't drop items onto the plaza itself. Then I got to work building the maze. I used hedge fencing since it's the easiest to use for building a giant maze like this. I also considered using regular hedges, but then I realized those would take forever to plant. As I built the maze, I went with the flow and built wherever I wanted. I wasn't following a template or any directions. I debated generating a maze online to follow along, but then I realized it was much easier to make a free-flowing maze from my mind instead of following someone else's design. A swirl here, a dead end there, a confusing passageway over there, and eventually it turned into this massive labyrinth that I'll be opening to all of you. I didn't make this maze island just to keep it to myself. So on July 28th, I am opening this maze to the public. My vision for this island is to have people come visit, and the best way to coordinate this will be by streaming the entire event over on my Twitch channel. Definitely follow me over there on Twitch if you aren't already. I stream almost all Animal Crossing content, so if the maze isn't your thing, I do lots of decorating, dream address tours, and so much more. Then, on July 28th, at 5:30 p.m. Pacific Time, 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time, I will start the livestream and pick players for each round using a random draw. I will hold multiple rounds of the game so many people will get the chance to play. As a thank you to my Twitch subscribers, aka members of the Blue Bear Cult, they will have twice the chance of getting picked in the random draw. So if you want to support me and my channels, consider subscribing to my Twitch channel. Subscribing on Twitch is equivalent to becoming a member of a YouTube channel, and it only costs $4.99. If you happen to be an Amazon Prime member, you have the ability to subscribe to any Twitch streamer for free. Again, if you or a family member is an Amazon Prime member, all you have to do is connect the Amazon account to your Twitch account to get a free sub and twice the luck to visit my Labyrinth Island. So if you want extra luck to get onto this maze island, consider subscribing or subscribing with Prime on Twitch. Once I pick the players from the random draw, I will send you the dodo code for the island in a private Twitch chat. Once you receive the dodo code, please make your way to my island in a timely manner. Now for the rules of the game. I'll also go over these rules before every round during the live stream. Once all visitors are loaded onto my island, I will assign a certain number and type of item for the team to collect. For example, I may ask for the team to bring me 10 oranges, 10 glow sticks, and 10 acorns. The items will be hidden in the maze, and I will not tolerate cheating. Then I will set a timer for 15 minutes. If the players bring me back all the necessary items before the timer is up, everyone wins. Winners will get a share of 1,200 Nook Mile tickets. If the team doesn't bring me back the specified items before the timer is up, then no tickets will be given. All items must be dropped in the plaza before the timer is up to count towards winning. If necessary items are dropped after the timer ends, then the team is disqualified. This is a team game, so I encourage players to communicate with each other via the Animal Crossing in-game chat or in the Twitch chat during the live stream. I will put all of these details about the event in the description of this video because I know it can be a lot all at once. I'm super excited to bring you this game that I love to play in New Leaf and give it a brand new life in New Horizons and allow new players to experience it and enjoy it. It took me a long time to build this maze, and I can't wait to share it with you and the Animal Crossing community. If you like this video, please consider leaving a like on it and subscribe to the channel for more minigame islands like the one I showcased today. Also, be sure to follow my Twitch channel for more Animal Crossing content. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.